Hey guys, what is up? It is Mandy here, and I have a new video for you guys today. It's been a while since I've filmed. Usually I film a video like at least once a week, but it's been like a little while, maybe like 2 weeks, but I mean, I think you guys have survived without my videos. But if you haven't, then here is a video for you. So today I'm going to be doing the how to survive or get through finals week, because I know that I'm currently going through finals week this upcoming week, so that's why I've sort of been stressing and, you know, not really sitting down and filming videos. I've been sort of just trying to finish up the semester, get everything done and over with, so that way, you know, I can go on to summer, because who doesn't honestly love summer? So yeah, I'm super stoked. Summer's my favorite season, so I'm just ready to plow through this week and get through it the best I can and make it out alive. So I have some tips and tricks for you guys, because I know a lot of my friends out there are also taking finals with me at college, and then also other schools, I'm sure, are still taking finals. And if you're not, then I'm sorry that this video is too late, because I know some people have already finished school, but I mean, better late than never, and also you can watch it for next semester. So these are some tips to just prep yourself and get ready to tackle finals week. So here we go. Okay, so the first tip I have, and my tips are my phone. I'm not texting. I always have to put that disclaimer. So my first tip is naps. Naps are extremely important and valuable, because especially if you stayed up till like 4 in the morning writing some paper or whatever, you know, you need your sleep. You need to be energized. Even if it's just a power nap for 30 minutes, you need to be energized. You need to have as much energy as possible to get yourself through. And if that means you have to take a nap, then do it, because it's going to make you feel really good. The next thing I have is caffeine, so either coffee or tea, whichever is your preference. I wouldn't recommend energy drinks, and the reason why is because the side effects are a little cray-cray. I mean, you could probably, like, I don't know, overdose on those things. I don't even know if that's possible, but I just don't trust energy drinks. I know that they give a lot of energy, but then you, like, crash, like, and when you crash, it hits you really hard, and I don't know, I feel like they're sort of addicting, like you have to keep drinking them and drinking them. Although, you know, coffee and tea can be like that too, more coffee than tea, but still. I would recommend either getting a nice tea that has caffeine in it, or a coffee, some form of coffee, because we know you need to have that extra boost of energy to keep you focused, and, you know, it's a stimulant, so it will help, you know, keep you really alert and focused, so it'll help you study, especially if you didn't get, like, a ton of sleep and you don't have time to take naps, then I definitely highly recommend caffeine. The next thing I have is meditating. Meditating is a wonderful thing to do, especially when you're stressed, and just to get yourself really in the zone and, like, concentrating and just relaxed. But, like, you know, when you're meditating, you are relaxed, but then that really helps you to work afterwards, I feel like. So meditating is something that's very helpful, or yoga, because yoga is a very good relaxing exercise as well. So either one is good. Snack breaks. Yes, snacks. You guys need snacks, okay? Because that's going to help keep your energy up, and it's going to help you concentrate and be able to focus better, because you'll have the energy from the snacks that you're ingesting, because you get energy from food. So it's important to have snacks in the middle of, like, your, you know, studying. Like, it's just very important to have them during the day to help, you know, re-energize yourself, because you're going to need as much energy as you can to focus and study hard. Comfort food, along the lines of food and snacks. Comfort food is something that you guys can definitely indulge in, especially during finals week, because you're going to be stressed as all hell, and we all know that you would definitely sit down with a bowl of mac and cheese and just eat it, because It's finals week, you're stressed, and nothing makes you feel better than eating the food you want to eat. So if you want to eat brownies, if you want to eat chocolate chip cookies, if you want to eat mac and cheese, if you want to eat mashed potatoes, whatever your comfort food is, or the food that comforts you, indulge in it, because it's finals week, and you're stressed, and you're cramming, and you're trying to get all this work done to wrap up the semester and finish it off strong. So eat that comfort food. Do not deny yourself that comfort food, because that is just going to hit you in the face and you're not going to feel good or happy about it. So yeah, eat that shit, girl or guy, whoever you are that's watching this. Comfy clothes, along the words of comfort. Comfy clothes. Oh my god, do not wear like freaking business casual attire if you don't have to, because it's finals week. Most people, when I walk around my campus, I see them wearing sweatpants, sweatshirts, you know, baggy t-shirts, whatever, and their hair's up in a messy bun. No makeup, girl. The makeup doesn't even need to be on. I mean, I'll put like a little face something something and maybe a little mascara if I'm feeling, you know, fresh, but during finals week, no, you don't need to do the full face and makeup. You don't have to actually put effort into your appearance or your outfit, because you're probably not going to have time for that, to be honest. You're going to be studying and working hard, and that needs to be your focus, not necessarily putting effort into your appearance. And I know you guys are probably thinking that's hypocritical, because right now I'm wearing makeup and my hair is done, but this is the day before finals week actually officially starts tomorrow. So this is the last day that I sort of really put some effort into, and I'll probably put some effort in the end of the week, because then my finals will pretty much be over, but you know what I mean, guys. You know what I mean. So be comfy. Good night's sleep. Guys, seriously, I cannot emphasize this enough. I know so many people that literally just don't get sleep. They don't sleep. They just, you know, stay up and they run on caffeine and whatever willpower they have left. And I think it is dumb, because you're going to crash. You're going to need to sleep. And you can't sleep an entire day away, because that's an entire day wasted of you sleeping. You need to get the sleep you can get at nighttime, at bedtime. You need to go to bed at a decent hour, especially the night before an exam, because you do not want to be up all night cramming before that exam, because when you wake up or whatever, or when you go to the exam, you're going to be exhausted. Your brain is going to be fried. You're going to have absolutely no energy to do anything. And yeah, you can force yourself to have energy with caffeine, but that's only going to last like so long, and then you're going to crash. So get a good night's sleep, guys, because seriously, like, it's a life changer. It's a lifesaver. If I don't get a good night's sleep, honey, I am not a nice person the next day. Like, you don't want to be around me. So, like, it's really, really important that you get a good night's sleep. So I cannot stress that enough to you guys. Please get a good night's sleep and go to sleep at night. You know, I would say the minimum amount that you should get during finals week, the minimum amount I suggest on a daily basis is 8 hours. But during finals week, I can understand you might want to cut it down a little bit. So 6 hours. 6 hours is the minimum amount that you need in order to, like, function like a normal human being. You need at least 6 hours. And I'm not going any lower, because, honey, any lower, you're going to be dying in that exam. So get a good night's sleep. Incense and candles. Yes, I love, love, love incense and candles. If you guys know anything about me at all, you know I do. If you've seen my Primark video, you saw I bought like a shit ton of candles. I can just show you guys some of my incense that I have. I have incense sticks, and then I also have these candles. Here's my elephant candle that I got from Primark that I'm obsessed with. I've already used it 3 times, and it's already like down to here. So yeah, if that says anything for you guys, I absolutely love candles, incense. Use them, because believe it or not, whenever I'm sitting down and I'm doing work and I need to really focus and concentrate and I have a lot of work and I'm really stressed, for whatever reason, when I light a candle or have some sort of incense burning, it really relaxes me and sort of gets me in like a zen sort of zone, if that makes sense, like a very chill, relaxed mood, definitely less stress. So I highly, highly, highly recommend getting candles and incense when you're doing work and lighting them, and just having that smell waft into your way, because that is just going to make you feel very calming and relaxed. And I don't know what it is about fire or like flames, but that also relaxes me too. So like seeing fire, smelling fire, you know, those sorts of things relax me as well. So I highly, highly recommend lighting incense or candles. So yeah, massages, girl or guy. I keep saying girl because, you know, I know a lot of you ladies watch me, but I'm not going to exclude you men out there that are studying for your finals too. So massages, yo, massages are going to change your life. I'm not even kidding. Okay, massages will make you feel so good because your back is probably so tense because you're so stressed. You're probably carrying tons of books with you in your little book bag or whatever, so I'm sure your back is slowly breaking. So you need a massage to loosen up those muscles that are so tense, and you just need that massage. So just ask your friend, anybody around you that you're comfortable with, that you know personally, just be like, hey, can you give me a massage, you know? And then you can give them a massage, and it's like a massage train, you know? You can, like, give one to each other, and yeah, it's just gonna make everybody feel good, because nobody likes to be super duper stressed during finals week, so that will help a lot. And nobody wants no tense muscles, honey, no, that's not gonna help you work hard, trust me. Next thing, chocolate. Who the heck doesn't like chocolate? Okay, I know one girl that doesn't like chocolate, and she's my sweet mate. Yes, I'm calling you out, Jaleesa. I love you, girl. But I don't understand how you don't like chocolate, because chocolate is like my heaven. It is a wonderful substance. It also contains caffeine, which is amazing, especially if it's dark chocolate. But seriously, guys, eat some chocolate, because chocolate makes you feel so good. It just has so many wonderful things in it that it does. It makes you happy. It energizes you. It's just a wonderful, delicious treat, and you need to reward yourself, because even though you're, like, plugging through all this hard work and you're just trying to get through, like, you need to take some time for yourself and reward yourself and treat yourself, because you need to, okay? Hanging with your friends, and this is what you need to do during your work breaks. So during your work breaks, you know, if you're going to get a meal or whatever, you can get a meal with your friends. You need to do something social, you have to have some sort of social break in between your studying, because you will literally lose your ish if you're not having any social interactions within your day, and you're just sitting there, like, cramming all this stuff in. Like, yes, that's usually what, like, finals week looks like, but you need to have some social interactions, otherwise you're going to go insane. You're going to drive yourself up a wall, batshit crazy, okay? Everybody needs social interaction and, you know, just being able to have a conversation with somebody else other than having a conversation with yourself while you're studying all this stuff. So you need to incorporate some sort of social interaction or conversation into your day. Okay, next thing is working out. Working out is a wonderful way to, you know, release or get rid of stress, and it releases endorphins, so it makes you happy, and it also keeps you really motivated. Whenever I go to the gym, I feel super motivated to do a bunch of other stuff, like after, like I always feel motivated to do my work, and it's wonderful. I mean, it just helps, like, get your energy going and gets the blood pumped and moving. So it's just a wonderful, wonderful way to help you concentrate and just, you know, get some energy going. So, yeah. The next thing is a shower. Girl, guy, I know I always say girl. It's a habit. Seriously, you guys need a shower. Like, I don't care who you are, but your hygiene should not be, put off because it's finals week, okay? I don't care who you are, you gon' stink, alright? You gon' stink if you do not take a shower. You need to take a shower. Use some deodorant. Put some perfume on. Have the body wash, the shampoo, the conditioner, the shaving. Whatever you gotta do, you gotta do it, okay? Because hygiene is key. Hygiene is important. You cannot not be hygienic during finals week. That's not an excuse to not be hygienic. I'm not saying that, oh my god, you missed one night of a shower, gross. That's not what I'm saying. If you miss one night, okay, whatever. If you're missing, like, every day, multiple days in a row, that's not gonna fly, because you're gonna have other people around you, and they're not gonna be wanting to come up in your business, you know what I'm saying? Because they just won't, because you're gonna stink, you're gonna be gross, like, you need hygiene, it's important. Brush those teeth, you know, take that shower, okay? Just do it, okay? You're not gonna regret it. Downtime. Have some downtime, guys. And that means Netflix and freaking chill. And if not Netflix and chill, watch some YouTube videos. In fact, you should watch this YouTube video. During your downtime of studying during finals week, just click on this video. It will make you feel awesome and you'll have some good tips. Or click on any video you want. But seriously, guys, have some downtime. Make time for it, because your brain needs time to relax. And, you know, just take a break from all that information that your brain is constantly absorbing that you're trying to study. So you need to take a break. Have some downtime at the end of the night. I'm going to have some downtime tonight because I've been working on a paper thing today and also a film project. So I'm going to have some downtime tonight. So, yeah. Stay hydrated. Drink lots of water. Drink lots of water, and even smoothies, if you guys like smoothies just as much as I do. Drink, because if you are not hydrated, you will pass out. You will pass out, and you will be dehydrated, and it will be scary, and nobody needs to be getting hospitalized for dehydration, okay? Stay hydrated. Always have water. See, look, I have water right here. Always have water on you. Seriously. It's nothing is worse than trying to concentrate when you're dehydrated. It's like you're going to start seeing things and passing out. Like, just don't do it. Always have water. Always. It's important. It's key. Okay. Switch up the subjects that you're studying. So what I mean by this is sort of don't, you know, if you've been focusing on one subject, like studying for one subject for like 2 or 3 hours, you need to switch it up, because your brain is gonna get tired of looking at the same old material. If you're anything like me, your brain is gonna get tired of looking at the same old thing for so many hours. So you're gonna wanna switch it up. So switch up the subjects, change the subjects, study for another subject for another hour or two, and then go back to what you were doing before, because your brain needs a break from looking at the same information. It can only look at the same information for so long and absorb it for so long. So you need to, in order to keep your focus going and keep your motivation going, you need to switch up the subjects, because that's going to just help you study all around. And then my last but not least tip is deep breathing. Just take deep breaths, especially right before you go into an exam of any sort or right before you're about to pass an assignment in. Just take, like, deep cleansing breaths. And I cannot girl, I know you were thinking that. Or boy, I know you were thinking that too. Anyway, no, but seriously, guys, deep breaths. Okay, it's so hard to say. Deep breaths. Take the breaths in. Not the breasts, the breaths. Okay, we get that it's not about boobs. All right, so take breaths in. Just take them in, you know what I mean? And that's really going to help you, because I know that helps relax me and keep my mind at a relaxed place versus, like, when I'm really tensed up and, like, freaking out before the exam, because that's usually how I am. If I just sit outside, take a couple deep breaths, inhale before looking at the exam, before passing in whatever assignment it is, it will just make you feel a lot better and more confident going into the exam. So, that is all my tips and tricks for you guys. If you like this video, please make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you want to see more of me, then make sure to subscribe. All right, I love you guys so much, and good luck with your finals. I'm here in spirit. Use these tips, it'll help you. All right, bye guys.